business degrees and meteoric career. But the boss of Uralkali, the world's largest potash producer, is now more in need of Soviet-era survival skills. For 2 weeks, Baumgartner, 41 years old, has been held in a Stalin-era Belarusian cell, facing up to 10 years in jail on charges of abusing power and seeking gain at the expense of Belarus. With IRN USA Radio News, I'm Ron Allen.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS that you can't pay? Call now for immediate help. 866-657-8517. At Community Tax Relief, we help consumers like you. If you take on the IRS alone, you could be facing levies, liens, even wage garnishments, personal or business tax issues. If you owe the IRS $10,000 or more, they will aggressively come after you. Protect yourself and your family today from what the IRS can do to you. Call now. 866-657-8517. They can freeze your bank account, even garnish your wages. Our expert team of tax professionals can solve your tax problems once and for all. Call now for a free 5-minute tax debt analysis. 866-657-8517. 866-657-8517. 866-657-8517.
Welcome to Animals Today, your home for a serious talk about animals. I'm Dr. Peter Spiegel, and with us today, we are pleased to welcome Jan Kramer, co-founder, CEO, and president of Animal Defenders International, which has been taking the lead in opposing traveling circuses in many South American countries. And the new film about this is now out, and appropriately, it is called Lion Ark. Welcome, Jan.
Hi, Peter. Very nice to be speaking with you. Thank you for inviting me.
Oh, we're so excited that you're joining us from across the pond. How did you all become aware of the situation happening in South America with the traveling circuses?
Well, really, the story started with a two-year undercover investigation. Animal Defenders International has been sending people to work undercover alongside the circuses and circus workers for about 20 years. And we've worked all over Europe, the UK, the US and South America. But this particular series of bans that we've had in the last few years in South America started from a two-year undercover investigation. And our team worked in circuses all over South America, and we then launched in several countries, Bolivia, Peru, Ecuador, Colombia, and we put to the people in those countries something that most ordinary people, it doesn't matter whether you are pro-animal campaigns and you're working for animal rights, or whether you're just the person in the street who is just compassionate and just doesn't think it's right to be cruel to animals. And what we put to those the public in those countries is that, you know, fundamentally this is wrong. Using animals in entertainment like this is wrong, and to make animals suffer in this way just for a few minutes of human entertainment is just wrong. And people agreed with us, and we got a ban in Bolivia, went first. We've just got bans in Peru and Colombia and Ecuador, and just a week or so ago in El Salvador. So the campaign has really, really gone global in South America, and we're certainly seeing that response in the United States, where we have circus campaigns all over the U.S., and people are looking at the issues of animals in circuses, and they're saying, you know, this is wrong. To make these animals suffer just for entertainment is wrong.
Now, you utilize some interesting techniques. I know you can't disclose them all, but you do infiltrate and utilize video, don't you?
We do, yes. We use body cameras, and we use remote cameras. Basically, our objective is to make, as far as possible, an objective study of what day-to-day life is like for those animals. How do the workers treat them? What sort of facilities do they have? What sort of confinement is there? And is there any opportunity for those animals to perform their natural behaviours, especially for the wild animals like the lions, tigers, bears, elephants, and animals like that? And our objective is, the reason we work alongside the workers and our people take the role or as a worker, is so that we can see how they interact with the animals without us influencing what is happening. The problem with a lot of studies that are sometimes done of these situations is that the workers know that someone is coming to study them, and so the person being there changes everyone's behavior, including the behavior of the animals. And we also record animals, how the animals behave when there are no humans present, so that you can get an idea of how they're feeling and how they interact with each other. So it is absolutely crucial. There is no opportunity to understand exactly how these animals live unless you lift the curtain and look behind the scenes.
Yes. Now, after the ban was secured in Bolivia, there's a long and arduous and complicated process of rounding up the animals and getting them to safety. Can you briefly describe that?
Yes, absolutely. Once the Bolivian Congress voted to end the use of animals in circuses, they gave the circuses a year to dispose of their animals, to sell them or to give them away or to retire them. And when the year was up, just one circus gave up their animals voluntarily, but about another seven defied the law. And this was really an undertaking that we had to give to the Bolivian government at the outset. We said to them that if they needed our help to seize or rescue or relocate animals, then that we would help them, that we would stand by. One of the problems a lot of governments have, as you can imagine, is if you ban the use of animals in circuses, what do you do with the animals? Who's going to step up and help you relocate them and deal with those animals? And so we always said to the Bolivian government that we would undertake to do that, and we said we would stand by them. So they asked us to go back. They asked us to go back after the deadline had passed and these circuses were defying the law, and some of them were gradually moving towards the border, and it was clear they were going to make a run for it into other countries and take their animals with them. So they asked us to go back and help to organize the seizures. And we had we went various ways. It's a huge country. You don't imagine how big Bolivia is until you think, well, it's California and Texas combined with hardly any roads.
Wow.
It's just all rainforest. So the logistics were very difficult, but we had a lot of help from the Bolivian wildlife officials were very young and enthusiastic, and they wanted to make this law stick, and they wanted to do the right thing. And we went, in a space of a couple of weeks, we went to about seven circuses and seized all of their animals. And the indigenous wildlife native to Bolivia were rehomed in Bolivia. The domestic animals were rehomed in Bolivia. But what they particularly wanted was for the exotic animals to be removed. So we took, in total, 25 lions from Bolivia and brought them up to the U.S. And took them to two sanctuaries.
Incredible. And the film, Lion Ark, depicts this and more. Tell us a little bit about the film.
We realized that we had a really special story, and we wanted to do something. We wanted to tell the story in a way that people would understand why we do what we do and why it's important for people to step up and take action themselves and do something about the way our world treats other species. You know, the fact is that these other species are stuck on this planet with us, with the neighbors. And, you know, the human race hasn't been a particularly good neighbor for a lot of animals. And really, we wanted to tell that story in a way, in an intimate way, but also for them to see the highs and the lows. And so it's kind of more of an action-adventure-style documentary. It's not your normal type of documentary, and we wanted people... It's quite... You see the rough and ready of how the rough and tumble of how these rescues are actually achieved, and you see us go head to head with the circus owners. There are some who don't want to give up their animals, and there are kind of threats, and there's lots of shouting, and someone gets a knife out, and this kind of thing, and really. What we had to show people was how important it is and how you can achieve what you need to achieve if you just stand up to these people. And that's right. Really what we wanted to show in this. And they were spread all over Bolivia, and we had to create a temporary line-up compound, a temporary kind of mass unit. And we were very lucky that the mayor of Santa Cruz was very kind. He gave us some land, said we could pretty much do what we liked with it. And we built a temporary holding center so that we could just then go out all over Bolivia and just bring these animals back either by truck or by air or whatever we needed to do.
And the film is right now on the international circuit. It's a great film. Jan Kramer, Animal Defenders International. What's the website?
The website is lionarkthemovie.com.
Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for inviting me.
Stick around. More with Animals Today after the break.
For all these cats and dogs. One unfixed female cat and her offspring can be the source of more than 400,000 cats in 7 years. One female dog and her unfixed offspring can produce about 67,000 puppies. Too many cats and dogs are unwanted anywhere by anybody, so they end up being neglected or abandoned. Millions of healthy pets are killed in shelters annually in the U.S. on average. 70% of the animals that enter the shelter end up getting euthanized. Fortunately, there is good news. There's a new answer to this dilemma. We can help to stop killing these animals by having our pets spayed or neutered. If you want a new pet, how about adopting one? You can rescue a cat or dog and save a life.
This message is sponsored by Advancing the Interests of Animals. You can check them out at aianimals.org. That's the letter A, aianimals.org.
Hi, this is Dr. Lori Kirshner, and I want to thank you for listening to Animals Today. Make sure to visit us on animalstodayradio.com, where you will see all our previous shows, and you can download them free. That's animalstodayradio.com. Also, make sure to become a friend on Facebook. Animals Today gets a lot of its support from the nonprofit group Advancing the Interests of Animals. Check them out at aianimals.org. And I hope you'll consider making a donation to help pay for the ongoing broadcast of Animals Today. Each week on Animals Today, we strive to bring you the highest quality, most up-to-date information about all animal welfare topics, and we certainly would appreciate your support. That website again is aianimals.org. And thanks for listening.
You've had 60-some-odd years to prepare for this moment. 60-some-odd years that added up to a squishy, squashy backyard squirt gun battle. And it's here, in this healthy little water war with your grandkids, that the question hits you. How did I get here? Is it just living in moderation or saving with gusto? Like getting 20% off your Rite Aid purchases every first Wednesday of the month with Rite Aid's new Wellness 65+. 20% off Wednesdays help seniors save big on water guns and everything else. Wellness 65+ also lets you accumulate points for every prescription. even Medicare, that earn you up to 20% off your Rite Aid purchases fast. It's one more way Rite Aid is helping you stay here, now that you've actually gotten here. Here, soaking wet and slinking through your own rose bushes. Stop by your Rite Aid, enroll free, and save this Wednesday with Wellness 65 Plus. With us, it's personal. Certain limitations apply. See your Rite Aid store or RiteAid.com for details.
Football is back. For tailgating or watching at home, Reynolds, Hefty, and Johnsonville brands have a game-time winning lineup. Reynolds Wrap Foil, Reynolds Slow Cooker Liners, Hefty Waste Bags, Food Bags, Plates, and Cups, and the full juicy flavor of Johnsonville Brats. Fire up your grill and get those Johnsonville Brats cooking. Lay Reynolds Wrap Foil on the grill to help prevent the brats from burning and to make cleanup a snap. And for really easy cleanup, don't forget Hefty Waste Bags, Disposable Plates, and Cups. Reynolds, Hefty, and Johnsonville brands, the winning lineup this football season.
Attention roofing contractors and homeowners. The Home Depot is running a special on shingles from GAF, North America's largest roofing manufacturer. Buy a pallet or more of in-stock Timberline or Royal Sovereign shingles and get 15% off the everyday shelf price. Just visit your local Home Depot between September 5th and September 15th and save 15% on GAF Advanced Protection Shingles, the preferred brand of professional contractors. GAF and the Home Depot, the best choice for roof systems and accessories.
Hi, welcome back to the program. I'm Dr. Lori Kirshner. You're listening to Animals Today. In Taiwan, there is fear about a new rabies virus strain, and a new research study is being proposed that would use beagle dogs as subjects. Our guest, Dr. Neal Barnard, president of Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine, PCRM, says it's a bad idea. Welcome to the program, Dr. Barnard.
Well, hi, Dr. Lori. It's great to be talking with you today.
So thank you for alerting us to this issue. September 28th is World Rabies Day. So remind us, doctor, what is rabies and what is the issue at hand now in Taiwan?
Well, rabies is a virus that I guess it's famous for being so deadly. It's easily transmitted from one mammal to another. And when it infects you, the most worrisome symptom, of course, is the fact that it can affect the brain and is effectively uniformly fatal. That's the bad news. And people in Taiwan are concerned that there's a little animal that looks like a weasel that they refer to as a ferret badger. And some of these have come down with rabies. Now, that's not a big surprise, but the local authorities are saying, well, maybe it's a little bit of a new strain, and we're not sure if it will infect dogs or not and how transmissible it might be. So their intention was to take 14 puppies, beagle puppies, and infect them with the rabies from the ferret badgers, and then let them go ahead and develop all of the symptoms of rabies, which, believe me, you don't want it to see or to have happen. It's something absolutely grotesque, and we have opposed it on two main grounds. The first is it's unbelievably cruel. The animals who develop rabies have just an awful experience from twitching and seizing, and ultimately they will all die, but a particularly gruesome death. But from a scientific standpoint, it's just not necessary. So we have been working very hard to urge the Taiwanese government to understand that this is a cruel thing to do, and it is not. There is no scientific reason for it, and we believe that the listeners to this program will agree with us, and we would like to ask their help as well.
Okay, so can you tell us what you might be suggesting as an alternative to what
Sure.
they want to do?
Sure. Well, the whole idea, first of all, is can rabies be transmitted? And what we are suggesting is that they just assume that. If you are bitten by a rabid animal, you have to assume that the virus could be transmitted. So you don't need to do any new experiments in order to show that. We've always assumed that that's the case, and we're going to assume it's the case this time.
Right.
The second thing, though, is you need a vaccine. And we do have rabies vaccines, and you can test the effectiveness of a vaccine in the test tube. You can actually see very easily if let's say, for example, I vaccinate myself, or I vaccinate a dog, or I vaccinate people or pets or whomever. That's what ought to be done. So we can take this new strain of rabies virus. We can take a blood sample from anybody's pet who has been vaccinated, or human, say, shelter workers who are very often vaccinated, too. Take a blood sample, see if the antibodies knock out the virus. That's all we need to do. We don't need to do experiments on beagles. We don't need to do experiments on the ferret badgers. We don't need to do experiments on mice. All of these things are currently on the table in Taiwan. And I've got to tell you, I think what the issue is, they proposed it because they were in a panic about rabies. And they weren't really thinking, and since they proposed it, they don't really like to have scientists like our team telling them that they're old-fashioned. So that's the wrangle that we're in right now. So the plan is for them to go forward, but we're trying to stop it.
Right. And it's not just a matter of trying to save these 14 beagle dogs. It's really trying to educate them about future experimentation, correct?
It's both. I do want to save these 14 dogs.
Right, of course.
I think this is cruel and it's nasty and it shouldn't happen. But
right.
But yes, just what you said is exactly right, that we need to, whenever anyone proposes anything that's grotesquely cruel, whether it's a rabies experiment on a dog in Taiwan or whether it's using dogs to teach medical students, and for that matter, not just dogs, but any kind of animal, we have to back up and say, wait a minute, we know it's cruel. What can I do instead? And you have to do a good long thought process to figure out your way out of that experiment in some cases. But there's no substitute for doing that hard work.
Right. So what means are you employing to persuade the Taiwanese government to modify their protocol?
We have been doing a lot of things. We've been contacting them directly. There is a group called the Council on Agriculture in Taiwan, and we have been weighing in. We have a physician over there who is Taiwanese who has been speaking with them. But we also have a petition that I would hope that the listeners to this program might sign for us. It's a petition to the Minister of Agriculture there. His name is Chen Baoji. And you can sign on to the petition at our website, which is just pcrm.org. You'll see it. And we are really hoping that people will sign on to that. It's very hard for Americans to influence the policies of another country, as we know only too well in many ways. But I do think that when it comes to microbiology and science in general, American scientists are widely respected. So we are continuing to push, and I think that if they realize this is not helping their image, I think we have a shot at winning it.
Yeah. Okay, so I want to urge my listeners, go to PCRM.org, sign the petition. Let's save these beagles from really what is an inhumane, unnecessary experimentation. In the last minute or two, Doctor, how large a problem is rabies around the world, and where are the problem areas?
Well, there's really no problem at all for when people have no exposure to animals directly. But there's a very big problem, even right here in the United States, for people who work with animals, whether it's in a shelter situation or people who might deal with raccoons and other animals in the wild, where it does crop up here and there. And you do see it. You see it in India. You see it occasional cases in Europe and whatnot. So it can come up. So we're not underplaying the problem. What we're saying is that the solution has to be a smart one.
Right. Very good. Okay, again, it's PCRM.org. That's Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine, PCRM.org. We're speaking to Dr. Neal Barnard with the PCRM. Thank you so much for your expertise and information about this. We'll get the word out.
Thank you. And by the way, I want people to never feel daunted. Don't feel like you can't win. Just yesterday, we learned that the Military Medical School here in Washington, the Uniformed Services University, stopped all animal use for teaching medical students. We thought they would never change. They have changed. So there's no reason why we can't rethink animal use wherever it might be.
Oh, fantastic. Great news. Good last message. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Great to talk to you.
Okay, don't go away. And visit animalstodayradio.com, animalstodayradio.com, to learn about our radio show. You can listen to all the previous shows that are recorded there. They're archived for your listening pleasure. And Animals Today is sponsored by Advancing the Interests of Animals. That's AIAnimals.org, AIAnimals.org. And we'll be right back.
I never thought I could be part of something so beautiful until our little bundle of joy came along. I vowed to always be there to help my wife. Except on game day, baby. That's my T.O. time with little man cradling him tighter than a running back heading to the end zone and showing him how to become the biggest fan of football. Besides me, of course.
Crazy about football? Head to Sears for big TVs and big brands from Samsung to Sony. Get 36-month special financing on total electronics purchases over $11.99. This is the ultimate football experience. This is Sears. Subject to credit approval. See store or sears.com/football for details. Offer ends 10/5/13.
Sears Auto Center offers complete car care. But did you know we also carry convenience? We've got online scheduling, weekend appointments, and convenient deals, too. Right now, save up to $70 on road handler tires. Get $100 in Shop Your Way points. And we'll check your alignment, battery, and more for free. Come to Sears Auto Center for complete auto care. Hassles not included. Sears, where better happens. Offer ends 9/21. Members earn points on qualifying purchases. Subject to full program terms, available at shopyourway.com. See store for details.
If you're struggling to pay or haven't been making your student loan payments, listen carefully to this urgent alert. Have you been out of school for 10 or more years and you're still making your student loan payments? Are your student loans past due or even in default? Can't go back to school because of an old student loan problem? Fast Track Student Loans can get your student loans out of default, stop any wage garnishments, stop collection calls, and stop seizure of your tax refund. Give yourself a break. Stop the stress and get your student loan payments down to as little as $25 a month based on what you can afford to pay. One quick 10-minute call could help you solve your student loan problems. So call right now. Not available in all states. Payments may vary based on income.
800-685-0129. 800-685-0129. 800-685-0129. That's 800-685-0129.
If you're a responsible homeowner who's faithfully made your mortgage payments, you deserve thanks for doing the right thing. And I'd like to tell you about a powerful financial tool that rewards your responsibility. Hi, I'm Jay Farner, president of Quicken Loans, and the tool that I'm talking about is the Home Affordable Refinance Program, or HARP. HARP is designed to help you lower your mortgage payments. It's for responsible homeowners who are current on their payments, but due to the housing market, may have little or no equity left in their home. And even if you were unable to get a HARP loan in the past, new guidelines mean that now you may be eligible. Over 2.5 million homeowners have already taken advantage of HARP and are saving an average of $250 a month. If you're one of the millions yet to take advantage, call us today at 800-QUICKEN. To learn more, call Quicken Loans today at 800-QUICKEN or go to quickenloans.com. That number again is 800-QUICKEN.
Important terms and conditions apply. Call us for cost information. Equal housing lender. Licensed in all 50 states. NMLS number 3030.
Searching for a great hotel deal? Go from online to on the road with America's Best Value Inn. Book a room and stay between August 15th and September 30th this year and save 10, 15, or even 20%. The longer you stay, the more you save. Plus, you'll enjoy free internet, continental breakfast, and HBO at most of our 1,000 hotels in North America. Visit americasbestvalueinn.com for details. With value in our name, you know you're getting a great deal.
Done.
Because Susan switched to Geico and saved hundreds of dollars on car insurance, her retirement account wants to bake her a chocolate cake. But it can't. It's a retirement account. It doesn't have the upper body strength to lift a cake pan into an oven. Switch to Geico, and every time you see the savings, you'll know your retirement account wants to bake you a chocolate cake. But remember, it can't. It's a retirement account. It is, however, happy that you're saving money.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Have you heard? Proactive is America's top acne system because it's fast and gentle, and it's all about prevention. So stay tuned for a chance to participate in a 60-day trial to prove it. Do you have troubled skin, acne? With Proactiv, you can heal your acne and help prevent new breakouts. Right now, in this radio area, we're looking for just 50 people with moderate acne to demonstrate exactly how fast Proactiv works. The first 50 callers who qualify can try Proactiv risk-free for 60 days. And you get our dermatologist's clear skin or it's free guarantee. Plus, the trial includes our legendary refining mask and green tea moisturizer free. Be one of the 50 lucky people to complete this 60-day risk-free trial. You won't see this offer in stores or on TV. It's a radio exclusive. Supplies are limited and the trial offer ends soon. So call now. 1-800-569-4918. That's 1-800-569-4918. 1-800-569-4918.
Sheepdog, standing in the rain. Bullfrog, doing it again.
Welcome back to the show. I'm Dr. Lori Kirshner. So we were on a flight recently, and I'll just tell you this little story. And I was hungry because we were late. We didn't have a chance to eat lunch. We get on the flight. I ask the attendant if they had any peanuts. Yes. What did the attendant say to us, Peter?
After snickering at you,
right.
Where have you been?
He said, due to allergies, to peanut allergies.
Right.
This airlines doesn't serve any peanuts anymore.
Right. No more peanuts.
Right. No more peanuts. Okay. Whatever. Right. Whatever.
But it's a little. It seems a little weird because a person can encounter peanuts really anywhere. If you're peanut allergic, it can happen anywhere. I guess you don't want to have a bad.
Well, what if you're allergic to avocados?
I know. So that's one point. Okay. Where does it end?
Right. Exactly.
Okay. So first peanuts, then whatever foods.
Right.
Then perfume.
Right.
Right.
So we're sitting on the plane. That's fine. Whatever. And then.
And you're hungry.
And I'm hungry. And I'm cranky and grumpy. And right. I hate flying.
You do.
I do hate flying. I'm sipping my little water. So what we see, come on, is a passenger. And she's carrying a cat. Remember that?
Yeah.
A beautiful, beautiful cat in a carrier. Actually reminded me of one of our cats.
In a carrier. Right.
So I'm thinking, what the heck?
Yeah. You're thinking more than that.
I'm thinking more than that. So, you know, they can't give me a peanut because someone in the very back row might be allergic to it.
Yeah.
But they're allowed to bring on cats?
Right.
I mean, have you known anyone with a cat allergy? It could be. I mean, a lot of these cat allergies are a bunch of baloney, but people who really have, you know, allergies to the dander of cats. I mean, it's they can really
suffer. Do they die?
They can't die.
They're
uncomfortable for an hour or two
for
as long as they're staying in that environment. And
right.
I remember my friend Dean would come into my house once, and the cat would be put away, but he could just his whole face would swell up.
So that's not good.
Okay, so I can't get a peanut, but you could bring a cat on board. So
So.
Why?
Where is the line between sort of medical necessity and convenience and political correctness?
Good point.
Because I just see a convergence of mixed up ideas
here. Yeah. Well, that's a very good point. And I'll tell you what my thought. Now, listen, I'm okay with this. I'm an animal lover. So bring the cats on, bring the dogs on. I don't care. You know,
right.
I just wanted a peanut. That's all. But anyway.
Yeah.
I got to thinking this was probably a service dog, right?
Or service cat.
Okay, a service
cat. Therapy cat.
Right. Well, now that's a good point. Now, do you know what this is? So I did a little research. Do you know if that cat was a cat that makes people feel better and eases their anxiety or whatever? That's called an emotional support animal, which is different from a therapy animal or a service animal.
It.
Okay, so
emotional support, it's just like an associate's degree. And you go to 4 years and you get a bachelor of science.
Okay, let me explain it in better terms.
Okay.
Service animal, they do work or perform tasks, right? And the Department of Justice recently, a couple years ago, I think limited those animals to dogs and miniature ponies. So they perform a test. So if you're blind, the animal sees for you. If you need an animal to help you with mobility, you're disabled. Okay, so that's the service animal. Then the emotional support animal are those animals whose sole function is to provide support or comfort, right? They don't perform a task. They're not a service animal. And then you have the therapy animals. Okay. Therapy animal is a working animal. It's owned by a non-disabled person, and they visit hospitals and schools and nurses, and they brighten the spirits of the people it visits, right? So you had, remember back in San Francisco a few years ago, the camel was a therapy camel, Casey?
No, I didn't remember that.
Yeah, you remember
really?
That?
We talked about that?
Yeah, no, we didn't talk about it. I just thought you'd read about it.
So you bring in the camel, like, into the hospital?
Yeah, into nursing homes and hospitals, and it's a huge camel.
And camels, like, they relieve themselves sort of whenever they feel like it. I mean, you can't train your... Because, you know, there are stories about camels.
Well, I know the stories, but this was really sweet to watch. It was like a minute and a half clip video. I guess it didn't relieve itself at that time.
They had just cleaned up, and they were just about to clean up, and they have one good minute.
They had 10 takes of the minute and a half. And so it was a therapy camel, and her purpose was to go into various facilities and offer unconditional affection for these people. So now you get
no
back.
Spitting,
right?
No urinating.
But it's really sweet. You see, okay, does the camel enjoy it? I don't know. Would the camel be dead or not?
Right.
Otherwise,
maybe it's the best possible thing for that particular camel.
Right.
I don't know.
And we could talk a whole show about that. So then you go back to the service animals, and so now as I mentioned, the DOJ recently sort of changed their guidelines a couple years ago, because you get all these people that would bring in their snakes or their pigs or their
ferrets are popular.
Ferrets, right? Exactly, and say, it's a service animal. I need
right.
So. Back in 2009,
the whole industry of ferret vests sort of went down the tubes. So, Mr. Holder, thank you for that.
That's good.
Another wet blanket on our economic recovery.
So, Daniel Green in 2009, he had a 5-foot boa constrictor.
Yeah,
and that was his service animal.
And
so he would have this snake coiled around his neck,
yeah.
And the snake's name was Redrock the boa. And Redrock alerted his owner to an impending seizure by giving him a little hug around the neck. So this guy would walk into places, and it was his service animal.
Whose description is a little hug around
the
neck?
Well, I'm telling you. So this guy had grandma seizures, and... Uh-huh. Redrock's slight hug around the neck would happen at the first sign of an impending seizure, mm-hmm. which allowed the owner to remove himself from a stressful setting, take his medication before it happens, find a place where he's less likely to get hurt if it happens, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, and he would walk around and he'd just be freaking people out to see this boa around his neck, 5-foot boa around. So he goes into Burger King and everyone freaks out, and the manager dismisses him from Burger King. So... In any case, at the time, Redrock was protected under the American Disabilities. The Department of Justice, at the time, was redefining redefining service animals, and Redrock lost his status. Right.
Yes.
So then you have the emotional...
What would you do if you are a Burger King manager at that point, and the law is sort of in limbo?
Yeah.
And you sort of know a little bit about dogs. You've had one pony come through, caused quite a commotion. and so now you've got this guy with a snake around his neck.
Yeah, I probably wouldn't believe him.
Right.
Yeah, it'd be hard to believe. But I'm telling
you. You don't want the feds coming knocking and shutting down
your
restaurant.
I know, but I'm telling you, there's other stories that I read where people would claim this is their service cat, and they would put the cat on the restaurant table while they're eating, and the cat's just sitting there.
Right.
And people are looking like, what's going on there?
Right. You do have this expectation of no cat hair in your
dinner. So I think all this led to this redefinition of the guidelines, and now it's restricted really to dogs and miniature ponies. And so an emotional support animal, and this is interesting, so it's really a therapeutic pet, right? It's considered a pet.
Right.
But has special rights under the FHA, the Federal Housing Administration. So it's allowed to live in a no-pet housing, and has rights under the Air Carriers Act, so it can go into a cabin of an aircraft.
Wow.
Right?
Wow.
But it can't go into, you know, hotels that are not pet friendly, right?
Okay.
Or can't go into a Burger King,
okay.
Right? But you can have a cat go into a restaurant, into, you know, a apartment complex where there's no pets are allowed.
Right.
If it's your emotional.
So if I own an apartment building, and am I permitted to ask a prospective tenant whether they have service animal?
Well, I don't know if you're.
I'm allowed to.
I don't. That's a good question.
Yeah.
I don't know, but I think you're permitted to ask for documentation if this is emotional support animal. But my point is, going back to the original story, I bet you that cat we saw on the plane was emotional, right?
Or maybe not. Why not just a pet?
Or it could be.
Yeah.
And then it'd be back to our original thought. It's sort of bizarre. They can't give me a peanut, but they allow cat on. Okay.
So
that's okay.
Are you allowed to bring your own peanuts on planes these days?
Oh, good. Ooh. I'm gonna smuggle my own
jar
peanuts.
Well, not a jar. A
little baggie.
3.9 ounce package of peanuts. and just give them out.
I know. We're gonna try. I want my peanuts.
Try. I don't want. I'm gonna try to be on. Make some bulletin somewhere.
Okay, I hope you have news for us this next segment.
I have some news items that are gonna just blow you out of the water.
Okay, don't go away. You're listening to Animals Today.
As temperatures climb, please remember to never leave your dog in the car, not even for a minute on a warm day with the windows cracked and in the shade. The temperature inside a car can climb up in a matter of minutes, and it's enough to kill your pet. If you love your pet, leave them at home or with someone you trust. Keep them cool, comfortable, and alive. And if you see a dog or other pet in a car, you may only have a moment to save their life. Here are a couple of steps that you should remember. Make an announcement in the store or business the car is parked nearest to. And call the police department or animal control right away. Remember, it only takes a minute or two on a hot day to kill an animal left inside a car. Your swift action can save a life. Dogs are unable to cool themselves the way people can. Never leave your dog in the car, not even for a minute.
This message is sponsored by Advancing the Interests of Animals. You can check them out at aianimals.org. That's the letter A, aianimals.org.
This is Dr. Lori Kirshner, and I want to thank you for joining us on Animals Today. Each week, we explore the wide variety of important issues concerning the welfare of animals, how people treat them, and where they fit in our society. From whale protectors on the open seas, to lawyers in court, to scouts helping their local shelter, join me to get the latest on animal welfare news, stories, and events from around the world. And visit us on Facebook to join the conversation. That's Animals Today every week right here on the station, 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Also, make sure to visit us at animalstodayradio.com, where you can listen to any of our previous shows free. Animals Today brings you the highest quality, most up-to-date information about all animal welfare topics. Much of our support comes from the nonprofit group Advancing the Interests of Animals. Check them out at aianimals.org. That's aianimals.org. And thanks for listening.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS that you can't pay? Call now for immediate help. 866-657-8517. At Community Tax Relief, we help consumers like you. If you take on the IRS alone, you could be facing levies, liens, even wage garnishments, personal or business tax issues. If you owe the IRS $10,000 or more, they will aggressively come after you. Protect yourself and your family today from what the IRS can do to you. Call now, 866-657-8517. They can freeze your bank account, even garnish your wages. Our expert team of tax professionals can solve your tax problems once and for all. Call now for a free 5-minute tax debt analysis. 866-657-8517. 866-657-8517. 866-657-8517.
Little Bo Peep has lost her sheep because someone broke into her apartment and stole all her sheep, not to mention a 50-inch flat-screen TV. Luckily, the Geico Insurance Agency had helped her with renter's insurance, and she got full replacement. She has since trained her sheep to do voice impressions of various attack dogs, and now feels very safe. Visit geico.com to see how affordable renter's insurance can be.
It's not enough to just build it for real.
Yeah, I mean, before we start, we design it, test it, and redesign it virtually.
Yeah, it's just not a go until everything is absolutely ready.
Whether it's launching a rocket into space or new products to market, Siemens Industry Software is behind it from the ground up. Somewhere in America, an innovative company is defying the impossible. Siemens. Answers. Visit Siemens.com/answers.
Attention roofing contractors and homeowners. The Home Depot is running a special on shingles from GAF, North America's largest roofing manufacturer. Buy a pallet or more of in-stock Timberline or Royal Sovereign shingles and get 15% off the everyday shelf price. Just visit your local Home Depot between September 5th and September 15th and save 15% on GAF Advanced Protection Shingles, the preferred brand of professional contractors. GAF and the Home Depot, the best choice for roof systems and accessories.
Football is back. For tailgating or watching at home, Reynolds, Hefty, and Johnsonville brands have a game-time winning lineup. Reynolds Wrap Foil, Reynolds Slow Cooker Liners, Hefty Waste Bags, Food Bags, Plates, and Cups, and the full juicy flavor of Johnsonville Brats. Fire up your grill and get those Johnsonville Brats cooking. Lay Reynolds Wrap Foil on the grill to help prevent the brats from burning and to make cleanup a snap. And for really easy cleanup, don't forget Hefty Waste Bags, Disposable Plates, and Cups. Reynolds, Hefty, and Johnsonville brands, the winning lineup this football season.
Anxiety whenever you're near. High anxiety, it's you that I fear. My heart's afraid.
Hey, welcome back to Animals Today. This is Peter here. Hey, Lori.
Hi.
So you love planes.
Yes.
And peanuts. Well, I wanted to get a little snippet of that wonderful Mel Brooks tune because there is a very special 13-year-old gal named Brooke Martin. She's an inventor, and she was concerned about the anxiety of her golden retriever when she would leave the house. And so she decided that she was going to try to develop an invention to ease the anxiety of her dog while the dog was home alone.
Okay.
So she invented a device she is calling the ICU Pooch, okay, with the letters ICU
okay.
and Pooch, which is basically to enable her to do video chat with her dog and also to dispense treats remotely.
Really?
Yes. So it's a little box with video. I don't really know what the dog can see, and I guess audio too, and then you can click or get a treat to be dispensed to help your dog out. So this is not quite a product yet, but she is entering this into a competition for other middle school entrepreneurs, and we'll see what comes of it.
I would think it would sort of freak the dog out.
Well, maybe, but
you see some figure on. Uh-huh. So can they distinguish your guardian's face on a TV screen?
Yes, I wonder if, because they certainly, to my knowledge, a dog can't recognize their own face. They don't have that sense, and they're looking in a mirror that this is me, right?
Right.
Like we know a dolphin can.
Right.
So
they're hearing this voice.
But don't you think that dogs can, do you think dogs can recognize the sound of a voice over the phone? Do you think a dog can recognize that?
Likely.
Likely. Some dogs.
Right.
So maybe it's the the audible signal that the dog is responding to more than the video.
Yeah, but our dogs would say, okay, where are you? Where are you? And they would get nervous.
And they would trash the device trying to
right.
get the treats out. So I think that's her next phase, is to sort of nail this to a board and make it sort of
right.
more secure.
There's one treat that just came out of this little cannon. I'm gonna tear it up and get the other.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we'll see where she goes. But, you know, I just love inventors, and I especially admire the younger, really creative types who are looking to help our little furry friend. So we'll see what happens.
Okay.
With,
keep us posted.
With Brooke, and see if she, if this becomes a device in the market. SeaWorld update. It's like every day, another SeaWorld update. So a couple weeks ago, one of their little belugas,
I heard,
4 years old, found dead, short illness, brief illness, and gone. So it's like, when will it stop?
This is like the 10th one in the past several years, isn't it?
Okay, here's the statistic on that. You're very close. Since 1995, 13 beluga whale deaths at SeaWorld San Antonio.
San Antonio alone?
Yeah.
Wow.
And 5 of the 13 were under 5 years old. Other SeaWorld parks have not recorded as many deaths. So, you know, we should not have these creatures in these tanks, right?
Of course. When will we learn?
And
when another human beings get killed?
So, yes. The one theory put out is that the water is just too warm for these animals. They live in very cold water in the wild, and water's pretty warm in San Antonio. And that might be contributing to their demise. No one really knows what's happening.
No one knows. They always say, we're going to get necropsy. We'll get back to you. They don't get back to us. And then, you know, it's the deprivation that kills them.
Yeah,
it's the isolation that kills them. It's the cruelty. It's inhumane. It's inhumane.
So they, and you would think out, they would figure this out after 12 previous deaths that they'd have they guess they don't want to know.
Yeah.
So that's a shame. And, you know, we've reviewed some of the efforts made to expose what's going on in these marine parks, such as a SeaWorld. And it seems like the momentum is starting to build. They dropped their prices recently to keep the folks coming through. So that's taken as a positive sign.
Do you think the movie Blackfish had an impact on what's going on?
I think not only the movie itself and people who actually viewed it, but talk about the movie and what people reading reviews and I think it's starting to trickle into the general population a little more.
And hopefully it's educating people.
I'm sure it's educating people, and it's very compelling. I'm sure it's a very tough message to penetrate into the young families.
Yeah.
Who just want to let their kids see the whales. Dolphins.
Right.
In Japan, scientists are trying to refine and perfect their ability to freeze-dry sperm of endangered species to save for a future need. So they are apparently able to do this without liquid nitrogen, and so they can reconstitute it at a later time with water, and then you get viable sperm to help repopulate the Earth either after Armageddon or repopulate another planet after we screw this one up, or just to save the genetic material indefinitely.
Okay.
My source here has no indication about what to do with the egg part of the DNA complement, but scientists are working on freeze-drying of sperm. Do you think that we're going to just totally screw up this planet?
Oh, we are screwing it up right now.
I think we're going to make it uninhabitable.
I don't know.
We're
going
to destroy it.
It's a great question. I don't know.
I think you know, not exactly on point with our. Well, I guess we're going to ruin our planet. That's good to know about. But you know, I think it's we got to anticipate having to jettison this place and go somewhere else when we screw this one up really badly.
Yeah.
Or have a nuclear meltdown. But so I don't know. There you go. Freeze-dried sperm.
Okay. Ended on a positive note there. Okay. Well, thank you. And thank you for listening to Animals Today. This is Dr. Lori Kirshner encouraging you to nurture your love and compassion for the only other beings sharing our planet, the animals. We'll be right back.
The opinions you hear on the Business Talk Radio Network are those of the host, callers, and guests, and not necessarily those of this station, Business Talk Radio Network, its management, or advertisers. The information on the Business Talk Radio Network does not constitute a recommendation, offer, or solicitation to buy or sell any product or securities. Investing involves risks, so please consult a professional before investing. If you have any questions or comments about the Business Talk Radio Network, contact us at 203-323-7300 or at our website, businesstalkradio.net.
IRN USA Radio News, I'm Ron Allen. Researchers say the new group of individuals who will soon become eligible for Medicaid in many states as part of Obamacare will be younger, wealthier, and whiter. Researchers and health groups will talk about who these people are and how they defy the traditional notions of what it means to be insured by Medicaid. Cut from the cloth of Rudy Giuliani, the leading Republican candidate in the race to become New York City's next mayor, has had a far easier primary season than his Democratic rivals. But Joe Lota still has his challenges, starting with his current job as head of the wildly unpopular MTA. Authorities in Pine Bluff, Arkansas, say a 107-year-old man was killed in a shootout with a police SWAT team at a house in Pine Bluff, Arkansas, where he had earlier used a gun to threaten two people.
Hi, I'm Joe DeFina from Washington State. My wife, Meryl, and I have been working the Andy Willoughby three-step plan now for over 7 years. We love doing it. It's been the best way we found to work from home. It's been life-changing for us. We highly recommend the Andy Willoughby three-step plan.
This is Jeannie from Missouri. I've worked Andy Willoughby's three-step plan for 8 years, working in my spare time. I work with really nice people, can be my own boss, and I don't have to be a salesperson. This is something anyone can do.
Hi, how in the world are you anyway? I'm Andy Willoughby, the three-step plan home business system has been helping people find financial freedom for over 10 years, and I think we could help you too. What people like best about the three-step plan is you can actually have customers calling you, you don't have to be a salesperson, and you get to work with nice family-oriented people. To find out how you could start making more money working from home, go to 3stepusa.com. That's 3stepusa.com or call 800-480-2102, 800-480-2102.
The Egyptian army launched an attack against Islamist militants in North Sinai on Saturday, killing at least 9 people, according to security officials. 2 Egyptian soldiers were killed late on Saturday when an improvised explosive device detonated in a road in the North Sinai town of Sheikh Zuaid, near the border with the Gaza Strip. Qatar has faulted Israel for building Jewish settlements on Sunday after U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry briefed Arab diplomats in an effort to garner support for Israeli-Palestinian peace negotiations. The comment by Qatari Foreign Minister Khaled Al Attiyah, while consistent with long-standing Arab positions, came as the United States continues to seek to build momentum for the talks, which resumed on July 29th after nearly a 3-year hiatus. For the latest news and analysis, log on to IRN USA News.
Attention roofing contractors and homeowners. The Home Depot is running a special on shingles from GAF, North America's largest roofing manufacturer. Buy a pallet or more of in-stock Timberline or Royal Sovereign shingles and get 15% off the everyday shelf price. Just visit your local Home Depot between September 5th and September 15th and save 15% on GAF Advanced Protection Shingles, the preferred brand of professional contractors.